Welcome back everyone to another video on the update S&P. This is episode, I believe, number 5. We are currently at the gold farm that we just built last episode, and I gotta say, guys, this thing has been working amazingly. We have lots and lots and lots of gold down here. We actually got a lot of XP as well, and I went ahead and enchanted another armor set, which I actually don't have on me right now. But yeah, we have lots and lots of gold so far. We have some more in these chests as well. We do have to AFK here a little bit more because we did craft them down a bit. But yeah, this is actually working really, really well. So with that being said, today's video is going to be something involved with gold. And that's going to be a piglin bartering system. Now, the only issue with that is that I don't actually have a nether hub set up. So this could be kind of different. I don't know why I say different. I meant difficult. This can be kind of difficult only because, you know, the nether is kind of an untamed place. I don't really usually do stuff in the nether. So I did set up a little something, though. I did set this up. Uh-oh, get you out of here real quick. But yeah, I set this little bartering thing up real quick just to see if it works. And it actually does work. So, you know, we actually got 1.20 released recently. And I was hoping that they didn't actually change any of the mechanics that we actually had. I don't know if he's going to actually wear that helmet. No, he's not. Dang it. I was trying to put a helmet on him so he doesn't despawn. But if I was to actually throw some gold at this guy, which I don't have, he's going to basically instantly throw all of his items down because this gold block is moving back and forth. So I can actually set up a really cool bartering system for him and get that done. So the idea is to basically make a bunch of these like rooms that have all the pigmen in there. And we're basically going to have them all bartering at the same time. So I can go ahead and kind of destroy this now. The test is over. I can kill this guy. We can go ahead and start making the actual farm. It's actually a really simple farm. And also, I forgot to say that we also have another idea for today's video, which is going to be building our first shop. I know we have our firebrick shop so far. Hold on, let me break this thing. This thing is kind of annoying. There we go. But yeah, we have a firebrick shop right now, but I do want to build a bigger store. And I actually have a really cool idea for that, but that's going to be later in the video. First things first is getting the bartering system up, and the bartering system actually does go with the shop because a lot of the things I'm going to be selling in the shop requires the bartering system. So yeah, we're going to need this thing to have all of our store needs online. I'm going to put this on so these guys don't aggro me. And yeah, so we actually got this so far, and it's not too bad. I really just want the gravel, which is going to be really, really useful. Blackstone is kind of cool too. Obsidian is going to be cool too, and then also soul sand. So those are really the only things I really want. Everything else can kind of get like destroyed, or I might just hold on to it. Who knows? But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these. And I guess try to design some sort of farm. So first things first, we need to make the nether a little bit more safer. So I'm going to make a small little like nether hub, something temporary, just to like not be completely exposed to all the environment around us. Okay, so we have a bit of a box in here with deep slate to sort of just protect this area and make sure that nothing gets in. I'm going to add some sort of door or way that nothing can get right there. So now I actually want to probably build the actual bartering system like right here. That way I don't have to actually move anywhere. I get all done in one spot, and I don't have to like keep going in and outside of this actual little hub I have here. So I think that would be quite convenient. I'll place those in, and what I'm thinking of is just punching some holes like here, 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 and I guess here. And that's going to be all the spots. Now I will not lie, this is uneven, so I will go ahead and make this an even number. But now this is not the right number, so let me just do this. It's out, and then extend this wall over here, and that should do the trick. So let's do that and that. There we go. Nice. I mean, these farms are actually very straightforward. I don't really need like a tutorial or anything. It's actually really, really simple. It's just making them drop items very, very quickly to get a bunch of items. So what I will have to do is build a bit of a storage system. So I will need some more chests. This thing is going to drop a lot of items if I actually do things right. So we're going to need a lot of chests. So I'm going to grab a bunch of chests and hoppers, and I'll see if I can get this thing going. Alright guys, so right now I'm just trying to lure these guys over here with golden carrots. Apparently they like golden carrots. They like anything that's gold. So they're picking up the golden carrots, and I can just slowly entrap them. Now, I think once you barter with them, they don't despawn. I'm not entirely sure, but that guy hasn't despawned, and I went away a lot of times, so I think he's here for good. So I can probably go ahead and just call all these guys over here. I guess you could say I'm calling the hogs. And I go ahead and place one here, and hopefully he will come over here, and I can, like, just box him in real quick. I'll break this out of the way so it's has space. Okay, cool. He's distracted. We push him in. Oh, that's the wrong spot. There we go, and there we go. There we go. Nice. We have yet another piglin in here for our bartering. So I just gotta do that 1, 2, 3 more times. We'll have a 5 piglin bartering trading area. We can even extend it by adding more, but there probably is no need. We already have quite a bit. One of these guys is gonna be overpowered, so 5 of them is gonna be very, very good. Okay, we got some more that spawned pretty close. We're just gonna nudge you down here. Nope, nope, don't go anywhere. Yep, grab that. Actually, you, while you're here, you grab that. Yup. I'm gonna just drop you real quick. You take that one in case you don't want that anymore. And you're gonna go over here. Right, nope, nope, don't go anywhere. Nope, stay right here. Come on now. What? You don't want it? Okay, well, hopefully you grab it. Grab that nice, perfect, stay right there. That's perfect. Bam, bam. And let me in. Quick. Push you, and bam. Got it. All right, guys, so we went ahead and cleared out everything. This is what we got so far. We have an entire double chest, which is 2 shulker boxes of gravel, and we also have this one, which also has a full shulker box of gravel. We have a shulker box of quartz, just a little bit over that, too. We have some more right there. We have all of the soul sand. We have a bunch of nether brick here, a lot of obsidian, so we can actually start making our obsidian back from the gold farm. We have a lot of blackstone as well. We have a bunch of leather. I don't know what I'm going to do with all this, but hey, we got it. We have more blackstone, and I think that's about it. We also have a lot of water bottles, splash potion of fire resistance. Jeez, I'm struggling right now. But yeah, we have inner pearls as well. We have a lot of soul speed. So overall, this farm is very, very cool. I did use all of my gold, though. That was a lot of gold. We have even more obsidian here that couldn't actually fit inside here. We do have a lot of this stuff, guys. So I honestly don't exactly know what I'm going to do with all this, but the gravel, I definitely know where that's going to go, and then the quartz as well. We actually are going to need quartz in today's build, so I'm glad we got a lot of that. But yeah, things are looking really, really good, so I'm going to collect all the stuff that I'm going to use for now, which is going to be the gravel and the quartz. Actually, let me go ahead and just craft this quartz down real quick, and I'm gonna meet you guys on the flip side. All right, guys, so with that out the way, we can go ahead and start the next part of today's episode, which is building our shop. So I want to go ahead and collect some items. Some of the things we actually have right now is part of the build. So we have gravel for concrete, we also have quartz for the roof, but we need a lot of deep slate. Now I did collect some deep slate in here, so we have about 2 shulker boxes of deep slate so far. I might need more because the entire roof is going to be built out of deep slate, so we might need some more, but let's just see. It's basically going to be using tile deep slate, which I'm actually a very, very big fan of. So I got some of this here. We also have, hold on, let me just put this in here real quick, and we also have this one. Yeah, I gotta craft this all down real quick, but yeah, this is what I plan on using for the roof of the build and for some other parts as well. But yeah, guys, I'm really excited for this shop. It's gonna be really, really cool. Now, one thing I actually also need is some terracotta, and not just any terracotta. I need gray terracotta, and that's gonna be kind of annoying because they don't really have gray terracotta in the mesa biome, so I have to grab regular terracotta and dye it, and I also have to get, you know, black ink, which comes from a squid, to actually turn it gray. So that's going to be a bit of a hassle, but it's definitely worth it. I really like the design that I've already had so far, so I'm going to go ahead and grab those materials, and I'll be back with you guys once I'm finished. All right, guys, so a little bit has happened since the last time I've recorded. First things first, we actually did a bit of a live stream yesterday, and we went ahead and got this done, which is going to be the center of the area. I didn't actually record too much, but I do have some clips I can roll real quick to show you guys what basically went down during this stream.
I actually didn't know I went over it.
You have feather falling?
No. Oh, you don't think I'm good at... No. I'm gonna do my own thing. Never mind.
Get him. Want some entertainment? I got something for you guys.
Super, I'm scared.
Oh, he shouldn't have trusted me.
What'd you do?
What? No way.
Super, what'd you do?
That's so annoying. Okay, I'm not working on that anymore. That's so annoying.
And now we're back here in the world. So with that being said, we got that done. We do want to let the copper oxidizer turn, I guess greenish or bluish over time. So we're gonna sort of leave it like that. But anyways, our plan is to build our shop around here. And one of the issues is that I believe Skits' gold farm is going to be in the way. So I already asked Skits if I can tear it down and build it back somewhere else, and he did give me the okay. So I want to go ahead and tear this down real quick and we can get started on today's shop. Now, before we actually cut to the time lapse, I noticed that someone left a little something behind the sign. This wasn't here before. Mwah by Eco. For those of you that don't know what that means, basically, Eco, I don't know why, but whenever I'm AFK, he just says mwah, comes into me and tries to give me a kiss, which, I mean, honestly, sometimes I do feel kind of down, but yeah, I don't know why he keeps doing this. Leave me alone. I mean, I guess I can't blame the man. He's just trying to spread the love, but I do need to make some like anti-moi chambers because whenever I'm AFK, I'm always moi'd. Alrighty guys, so we got the majority of Duper Depot up for now. We have the landscape just a little bit, made a bit of a wall over here too, just to keep everything sort of level. The plan is to have about four paths going from each direction of this like center area and going through the mountains eventually. Now the issue is Duper Depot is blocking that. We have one path that's gonna go right through the bottom of here, and hopefully that should actually lead to the outside of the mountains, which would be, you know, much easier for people outside to get in with the elytras. And speaking of elytras, I have something for you guys in a second, but yeah, this is basically what we have so far. So I plan on having this go down as a tunnel and going through there, and then we have a bit of a walkway up here. I haven't finished all the rest yet, still got to do a lot more detailing, and I want to add some trees around here just to make things look a little bit more professional. Hey, these guys like carrots? Oh, they do like carrots. I was wondering why they just ran up straight to me. Oh, okay, that's kind of scary. Yeah, we also have to make the front door. I don't know why I decided not to make the front door. I'm kind of not really thinking straight right now, but yeah, things are looking pretty cool. We have this going all the way back here, so this is a pretty big build. Now, I didn't actually finish the roof in on the time lapse, but that's not really a big deal. You guys probably can already see the pattern going there, and this is going to go right into the back of the mountain. The reason why is for two reasons. Number one, this is actually still too small. This is supposed to go 60 blocks back, and I think this is currently only like 40. And also, if I just have it meet all the way in the back of the mountain, I don't have to build the back of the actual shop. So it's a win-win. I don't like finishing the back. The back's always the least detailed. So this is low-key a like 500 IQ like idea. I don't know. I think this is like a big brain right here. The inside is not finished. We haven't finished the floor yet, so we have a lot more work to do. Probably in the next episode, because we have some other things to do today. And I'll show you guys real quick what we've done off camera. So if I'm going to open my ender chest right here, you guys will see that I have some shulker boxes of some material, or not materials, but some certain items in the game that are pretty good. Long story short, I did go in busting. I went in busting for about 3 hours, maybe four, and I just went to every in city that I could find, and I only grabbed the ships. So I just went straight to the ships, grabbed Elytra, left, went to another ship, grabbed Elytra, left. Like, I didn't actually loot it all the way and killed all the shulkers and stuff, so I was able to save a lot of time and get a lot of stuff. Let me just sleep real quick before I get, like, attacked by a bunch of mobs. But yeah, we have currently about 2.5 shulkers. Elytra's right now. Yeah, we have this one, we have this, and then we have another one. There we go. There we go right there. And yeah, we have lots of good armor too. So I can make some armor sets just to have some spare ones for myself. We also got like a lot of good tools and stuff. This is actually like some really good stuff. I'm not gonna lie. This right here is really good, but I just wish it didn't have Curse of the Vanishing. But yeah, overall, it was a really, really good trip. I didn't want to record it because inbusting is really, really boring. It's very repetitive. But yeah, we did do that. And I honestly think that we've gotten most of the Elytras within a negative 20,000 to positive 16,000, you know, radius between the actual center of the portal and the actual, you know, outside. So we got quite a bit of Elytras from that area. And I went ahead and decided that, you know, I'm going to sell Elytras at Duper Depot. And one thing that's going to happen is every time I do sell about half a shulker box of Elytras, the price is going to increase because it's going to gradually get harder to actually obtain Elytras because of how far spread in the end they are. So yeah, it's going to slowly start to go up. Now I'm going to keep things a stack, okay? I have not designed the interior at all for this, but it shouldn't be too hard. I plan on making it just like a real like Home Depot interior. So, you know, lots of very tall shelves with lots and lots and lots of shulker boxes of items. And even probably in a department for a couple of other things. But yeah, that's my main idea. It's not going to be anything too crazy. Maybe some forklifts and other machines around just to make it look more like a hardware store. But that's the, you know, the general idea for the interior. So with that being said, I have to go ahead and design this interior. But if you guys did enjoy today's video, then make sure you guys check out my last video on the Minecraft channel. And with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace, love, and understanding always.